Yep, you saw it firsthand what the parabola beam does.
And Roll will go on to produce the Jerry Springer Show.
Dang. Let me see if I got enough to sound scramble them, it seems. Yeah, do something. Let me see if I got enough to make what I need to make for the rest of the bazooka. Probably don't. Probably the game's like, you need this now. Let's see here. Rusty, no. Where is it? Rusty bazooka. Yep, I need fireworks to make the thing work. I need one more item, I know where it is too. Just to make the strongest cannon in the world. Cause the best thing about it was the final weapon only takes two abilities. That's it. Unlike how it was in the first game, which it took 7 items. This one only takes 2. And they're really easy to find. So, hope everybody prepared, because now we're about to enter the Water Ruins, which is the longest dungeon in this whole entire game. Seriously, this dungeon will take a while. So, the sound gun turns innocent chicken into crazy, crazy psycho killers. Safe now, so now we can open the ruins. We got the rebreather, so now we can breathe underwater. So let's change our shoes then.
They make Bernie seem like nuclear physicists.
Let's change our shoes to the hydro jets, so now we can get underwater. We can do some underwater exploration stuff. Like I said before, if anybody knows. If anybody's ever played Ocarina of Time before and hates the water ruins or the water dungeon.
The second key is in here somewhere. Be careful, Mega Man. Don't rush things.
You played Zelda's Lullaby.
This is a really complex structure. Yes. Be careful you don't get lost. Again.
Yes, this is a really complex structure. The reason why this place is so confusing for because there's some places where you have to lower the water and there are some parts of the stage where you have to raise the water level. I don't have the power drill weapon because I don't have the power. I don't have all the abilities for it. But if I did, oh boy. Yeah, complex structure. I mean, maze. Yes, pretty much. Yes, maze. Big maze. Because like I said before, there's some parts of the stage you have to raise the water, the current, and some of the places you have to lower the water current. So for
there's
right now,
something that looks like a large water cliff in the room ahead of you. I'm not picking up any reaper boss.
So for right now, the water level's down for right now, so we have to raise the water level in order to progress this dungeon. Which makes Mega Man move slower! But whatever. Okay, let's jump down this cliff. Put this hole in the bank. There's stuff over there, but I can't get to it right now.
It looks like.
One way I can go to if I had the drill weapon, but I don't have it.
That step's really high. Too high for you to jump. If there was something,
you know what something is. I've been saying it about 12 times already. We have to raise the water level. Which is this nice button right here.
It looks like the floor beneath you is filled with water.
Now the place is filled with water, and now Mega Man runs slow as crap. But the Hydro Jet speeds it up a little bit, but Mega Man still runs slow as crap.
Maybe something's changed now that this area is filled with water. Since things are lighter in water, you can pick up things you weren't able to before.
The speed record. Also the zebra lights. Because apparently that's a good idea to have in a game.
Yeah. Well, I can't do anything about that. That's the game itself.
Why did the game incorporate zebra lights?
I have no idea. Exit 4. Because we're in water, Mega Man runs slow as molasses. He also falls as slow as molasses too.
This game is brought to you by VHS. And remember that annoying auto-tracking system that never worked.
Pretty much. So the funny thing about the flame guys now is that they shoot bubbles instead of flames at you now. The bubbles still hurt you, but they just fire bubbles. Can move normally for a little while. Then you gotta raise the world level back. So nice.
Well, you are Big Man Jesus, so of course you can control the elements.
Yeah, I mean, you can't get past that trap unless you lower the. The best thing about it is that you have the big floppy fish that will swim around and try to kill you. Because there's no water in here.
Oh god. It's like Chi Chi's for the Super Mario World.
Yeah, well. It'd be pretty bad once I have to raise the water level back up again. But right now, the water level's down, so I can just.
I'm throwing three Reavabots nearby. They're big ones, too. Be careful!
Yep. Three Reavabots nearby. That is the boss And they're easy as honor will take out with the water level down. With low water level up, they're a lot harder. Don't know where they are. There's a dead door over here. That's the boss. This is a boss, yes. The jellyfish boss. But there's no water in here, so haha.
Not fair for a boss fight.
Yeah, well, at least they'll hurt. Because they don't, I mean, the only thing that they can't do is move around. They do shoot energy blasts at you. But you can just circle through them. Well, what happened was is that this is the second game.
I'm reading what looks like a key, Mega Man. Do you see it?
This is the second game in the Mega Man Legends collection. I did the first game last year, so I mean a couple of years ago, last year or something like that. So this is the second game in the series. And the first game was good, the second game was good, and they were going to release a third game in the series, but it got canceled. And people basically got up and blamed Capcom about that ever since. Yep, and now we have to go all the way back and raise the water level back up again. Because I can't go up. Because of this, it basically made a lot of people jump up and go, I will never play a Mega Man game ever again. Because Capcom is evil and they suck and blah 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 blah.
Empty Virtue Signaling for 99%.
The same what happened, man. Just the same what happens. Yep, now we're gonna go all the way back and we gotta raise the water level back up.
I guess it's time for me to trigger all those people by saying, I'm watching this, but I don't think these games are particularly special.
I mean, they're not, like I said, they're not bad games to play. I mean, they have a really good story on them, and they have some really awesome music. The Legends series, though, a lot of people got really pissed off because Legends 3 was supposed to come out. So was another game on PlayStation Portable called Rockman Dash. Which is kind of like Mega Man Legends 1. It's like Mega Man Legends 1.5. And that didn't come over to America either. I think it's only stayed in Japan. Okay, so the water's here, so I gotta go. I gotta raise the water level back up.
And then return the zebra lines.
Sorry about that. When they say this dungeon is complex, it's very, very complex. Okay, I'm fighting you guys. Thank you. like, yeah, this one game, a lot of people get up and go, oh my god, this game is so awesome. You know, so you get to the third game, and it's like, I mean, it's like Mega Man Legends 3 never happens. Wait, did I raise me? Okay, that's what I did, yep. Okay.
So just my opinion is I'm not particularly impressed. It seems all right, but it seems like it's got where it's lost.
Still kind of messed up at how many people jumped up and say, I hate Capcom forever because of what happened and blah 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 blah.
Are you really surprised with Ways of Gaming? Are you surprised?
No, I'm not. Not it. Okay, cool. Because it's like, I mean, because basically, if you made the drill weapon, you can actually go through the cracks in the walls, but it makes the stage a whole lot much more complex because you basically be walking around in circles. Half a death going, am I going the right way? I've done that before when I had the trigger weapon the first time I played the game. And I never made it, I never made it again because I can't remember where to find the other part, the other piece of it. Alright, now the water is back downstairs, which is totally fine. Yeah. That's mostly where they're putting all of their franchises at now, because that's about it. And the only thing about it was that Resident Evil's been kind of old anyway. It's basically the same thing almost. Like most, it's kind of nice they added in the whole co-op feature thing. At the same time, like most of it don't work so well. Like when me and Izzy did it all, I mean, Izzy and myself did Resident Evil 6. I mean, it was fun, but at the same time, it wasn't really all that great.
It's one of my favorites.
There's a strong current there. You won't be able to get past it.
Yes, I can.
Wait! There's a switch really close to you. I'm reading four medium-sized...
Yep, four medium-sized Reaver bots in here. I'm gonna move past them because... The funny thing about it, I actually have Aminusha 3 on Steam, but it's been taken off the Steam page. But I still have it. I'm glad I have it too. I played it at the time. This is a really fun game, but I haven't played it since they took it off of the Steam page. Two games they have. I actually have two games they put on the Steam page. They took off the Steam page over stuff. Yeah. Because Amnesia 3 was on Steam, but they took it off the Steam page. Completely off the Steam page. So it does not exist. Okay, if I remember correctly, there's two keys in this area. I found one of them. Basement 4? Yes, I do. Basement 4. And guess what? More water!
Jeez, more zebra lights.
Yep, more zebra lights. Strange thing about when I looked it up on the Wonder website, just saying this now, they actually said on the 20th.
It looks like there's a door to another room high on the wall there too. Do you see anything to stand on?
I think it is. It is supposed to be the next Steam sale. The
27th. Thanksgiving sale. Alright.
No, 20. Well, no, they don't call it. No, they don't call it Thanksgiving sale. They call it the fall sale. Doesn't make sense.
Let's be real. This Thanksgiving sale.
Yeah, point taken.
With that timing, it's Thanksgiving.
Yeah, point taken.
And it's also Cyber, Black Friday.
Yeah,
Black Friday.
Yeah, but they actually call it the Black Friday sale too on one website. Like, okay, makes sense. Is it Black Friday sale? Is it the fall sale? What sale is it? Make up your mind here. Because if it's a fall sale, y'all should have had it during the Halloween sale. Because the Halloween sale is terrible.
Why? It's the Black Fall sale. I know the Halloween sale sucked.
The Halloween sale sucked terribly. Yes.
Although I did get Darkness 2 out of that. It looks like a very
good. Oh, yeah. That's pretty good. I mean, if you got something out of it, it's pretty good, dude. But like I said, I mean the game I bought doesn't work on my computer.
My tentacles can make black holes.
Yes. We know all about you. You're all alien powers of yours.
Yes, Jack Iskow is not a guy to be fucked with.
Yes.
You also have the some execution moves that are like wishbones and stuff. It's like, oh, damn. When if I stream that thing, you'll see some of those. You'll be like,
the question is, are you streaming tomorrow? Because I may not be here. Because my brother sent me a text message saying, see the Thor movie.
No, I don't plan to be. I'm not planning to stream on Saturday. Especially not for someone like us.
Okay, I'm just wondering.
My question is,
how it walks into a really big circle here? Because that's the problem with this dungeon. It's super easy to walk in a circle and not even realize it. Yep, I walk into a circle. Okay, let's go back. Let me check over here real quick and see if there's a hole in the wall or not. It's a hole in the wall, but like, yep, time to go back. Cause that's the problem with this dungeon. Yep, cracking the wall, whatever. Except for the other dungeons aren't like this. It's only this dungeon that's the main dish. Fish! Yes, only for this dungeon there. That's the beauty thing about her. It's only for this particular area. So much.
Found us.
sower, which is all cool. Okay, dude, like I said, I'm totally fine. Like I said, well, this dungeon's pretty long. So sorry if this is kind of boring a little bit. And you still blow up my face anyway.
Thought there'd be a place like this here. You see the large pillar in the middle of that area? On my scanner, I can see what looks like a key on top of it. Can you...
Pillar! Oh, it's no pillar right now, but I think I'm close to the boss area at least. Or to where the key is, at least. Getting close.
Hip hip hooray.
And by close, I mean I think I'm here.
Ooh. Thank God.
I told you, man, this dungeon's big. It's a big dungeon. Big dungeon. Alright, equip my machine gun arm. Let's go.
It looks like the key is in the room at the end of this passage.
Yeah, it looks like a key room. Oh, that's right. I thought so. Son of a brother. Yeah,
does it at least
they
seem
wouldn't
like
make
I'm trying, does it at least sound like I'm trying to suppress the cough here because I'm like...
No.
Covering my mic, covering my sleep, doing everything in my power to try to at least quiet it down a little bit.
It's fine. Yeah, but I thought I missed a key. There's a two-keyhole door.
Oh, so yeah.
But yeah, but that is the way. That is the way to the key door. I just gotta find the other key now.
Yeah, where do you find the keys? I'm pretty sure it was the first one.
Okay, I think I gotta go up. Yeah, that's a good idea. You gotta hop on. I thought I'd do something. You gotta hop on this rayfish thing, which takes you up.
Oh. Catch a ride.
Yep, catch a ride.
No, Ryu. In order to ride something, you don't use your head. You stand on the thing.
I was trying to stand on it. I just gotta get all the way to the top.
Yeah, that's called physics.
Yes, I know what physics is, sir. I'm definitely not high enough to make that jump to there. Which pillar is a centimeter? This pillar over here. Which is the wrong pillar. Okay. Jump, thank you. Okay, so what I should be able to do is if I air dash, if I war dash towards, I should be able to use that pillar. Here we go. Overshot the jump. Yep, totally overshot it.
Tisk.
I'm gonna try it again.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, see, that's it's a really short platform. You have to hit, but you have to hit it at the right time. You can overshoot it really, really easily.
I see that.
Like I said, I got the first key. That's at least a positive. So all I can do right now is get back to where I get to. Make the jump. This time, don't overhit the jump. Get the second key. There you go. Just gotta find that pillar. It's taking me to if it ever gets there. Let's try to see if I can jump it. Ha! I can jump it! Wrong pillar! Okay, so I guess it's... this way then? It's one of these directions. Ha 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 ha! There we go. Where the key to? There we go. There we go, dear. Let's just find the door I need to get to. Put the keys in. Fight the boss. Get out of this dungeon. Never come back here ever again. save again. Yeah, let's go. Yay, there's the key and no boss!
You did it! You got the second key!
Yay!
Good work, Mega Man!
Yay! Oh, nope.
I don't believe it. Bola lost to a little punk like you? Ha! If you think I'm a pushover like Bola, you've got another thing coming to you. I work for a living. I don't hold back, ever. Not even if I have to fight a little kid like you. You're not getting past me. Not as long as you have that key. If you aren't going to hand it over nicely, I'll just have to take it from you. Kid, you're not such a pushover. I haven't had this much fun in a long time. You wait. I'll be back.
Now, here's the downside about this dungeon. Usually when you find the keys, you automatically leave the dungeon. But because we fought him and because he's still alive, now we have to leave the dungeon manually. So we have to go back up 5 floors.
That's stupid.
Yep, Data's gone too, so can't use him to save. So let's go back up. Now we have to go back up 5 floors. Start from floor 4 all the way back up. But there's no water now, so that's at least a positive right now for now at least. Yeah, no teleports. The other two dungeons, there will be teleports. Once you get the key, you're done. That's it. You're done, you're out the dungeon, you're good to go. This dungeon, like the first dungeon, as soon as you get it, you're good to go. But now we have to manually get out of here. Yep, take your time, Big.
Remember, Big, be like Sheeta. Tell us exactly why you took the break. Mario Minds want to know this shit.
It's like I told Izzy before, you know. I mean, I talked to somebody else all the time, you know what I'm talking about. And that person talks about more than 3 things in the world. Because Sheena talks about 3 things, and it's funny to mess with her. Because she talks about 3 things. And we all know what 3 things they are.
Wrestling? Wrestling?
I was like, yep, we all know what 3 things are. There's no guessing, there's no anything. We all
yep.
know what it is.
Yep, wrestling, Izzy, and gaming or some shit, I think. Or corn shack.
She was talking about corn shack. She was talking about nah, she was talking about corn shack.
Didn't she frequent that stream though? Didn't she cheat on you by watching him?
I don't know what she does, I ain't worried about that. I don't really care. I mean, there's three things. There's wrestling, Izzy, and then the last and final thing in the world. which is what pissed her off.
Yes. Wrestling is whatever pisses her off.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, pretty much.
And usually the three are linked.
Yeah, pretty much.
Whether she's pissed off because of wrestling and needs to talk to Izzy about it, or whether she's pissed off at Izzy for some reason.
Yep. They should come in, here and be like, I can't believe you're talking about me again. Bleep, 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 bleep.
Yeah, well, don't put your foot in your mouth.
Pretty much.
That's offensive. Now you're offending me.
Yeah, because she's basically saying, I mean, I understand where she's coming from, because she basically said she's been bullied before, but I've been bullied before. And I don't sit here and treat everybody like they're common enemy number one or anything, you know?
Yeah, you can't be offended by everything, because if you're offended by everything, all you're going to be is a vegetable in life, and there's no way you're going to do anything being a vegetable in life. No way at all. You gotta remove the stick from your butt and realize we're not sworn enemies.
I was just gonna let you know, I am playing Earthbound for next year, and you're in the roster for characters. So is Izzy. I already told Izzy. Izzy bust out laughing when I told him that. I just thought I'd let you know too. Just in case you didn't see the video that I put up that says coming 2018. Then we need to bust out laughing at it.
Let's see, D got a spot.
Yes, D got a spot.
He deserves it.
Yes, he does.
Says I can't hit because I know Izzy may be the lead on his.
He said, oh no! Oh dear!
As long as he ain't Porky, you're good.
No.
No. Ryu, you did it.
I didn't do what?
You did make D Paula, did you?
Oh heck no! What kind of sicko you think I am? Where are you?
Three options, as far as I know. Oh, you're four options.
Four options, you think I made them?
Ness.
Nope.
A girl.
Nope.
A bedwetter.
Which one's the bedwetter?
Jeff. And, some bald.
Well, I didn't know he was a bedwetter. I knew he was the repair guy. Sort of.
The parents give you too much information, so they tell you about the numerous faults that person has.
Oh god.
So, congratulations, D.
I didn't make you a better one, D. I just said, hey, D hasn't been long to me, and I just put him in mind. If it's cool.
Yeah, that's actually pretty cool. Ball.
Yes, you guys.
When if I do Chroma Squad next year, I gotta come up with 5 people.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm sure I'll be in the roster, no problem.
Well, then that's you like that, I won't put you in the roster.
Well, dang it, man.
I could make you the 6th.
If you want to.
Nah.
Yeah. Yeah, my name is Tammy, the 6th Ranger. Yeah, that's the name.
Yes. Ryu, when did you get boobs?
That's a good question. No D. I mean, he's being serious. I did make you Jeff. He's being serious.
I'm sorry, D. I tried to talk about if you being a bedwetter, but...
I didn't even know, man. Why did you bring a doll bedwetter crap for?
I never played Earthbound and I know this.
Yeah, I just played it. You know, I played Earthbound because it had a good storyline. The whole bedwetter thing. You trying to act like I did that on purpose or something?
I thought I told you to wait.
No, I'm trying to say that there in Earthbound there's not too many viable options.
A little more and I would have lost you. Okay then. Ready for another round?
I'm gonna take out armor. Yes, he now has a destructive disc. So he learned from these.
Krillin?
Learn from Krillin. Yeah, it's so fun. It's got these bombs everywhere, which is cool.
Stop this!
Heads up! I am dodging. I'm dodging your currently destructive disc.
You're pretty strong, aren't you? That's a big gun you've got.
That's a big
but
gun.
It's not enough.
That's what she said.
Me. You kids.
That's not how
so
this
hot.
Works for you.
Well,
you don't
still some fight
reflexively go. That's what she
childhood.
Said immediately after making a statement.
And then he hurt his back.
My back.
It ruins its effect.
I can't move.
Whatever. But then he hurt his back.
Help me. Somebody, help me.
Well,
I thought I was supposed to be your partner, not your nursemaid. We're willing to call it a draw if you are, boy. Come on, Claymore.
It's time for the bro code.
Oh, if it weren't for my back.
Hey, what's up, D? That was a gold.
What are you doing to say that, David?
I am fully in How I Met Your Mother. I watched that.
You're in
nice.
Wait, he's in what now?
How I Met Your Mother mode.
Bro code.